Part 1 of 3, Drugstore Cleansers. Hey guys, it's Jules. In today's video, we're going to go over drugstore cleansers. 3 videos. One on drugstore cleansers, one on drugstore moisturizers, and one on drugstore sunscreens. The drugstore is such an easy and accessible place to buy your cosmetics and your skincare. I thought it was a really good place to start in terms of teaching you guys and informing you guys about cleansers and what is available right now. There are many, many cleansers and cleansing products on the market. If you're interested in a video that shows cleansers from higher end brands, please let me know and I can definitely do that for you. Cleansing is so important. It is not acceptable to use a bar of soap and water. We definitely need to elevate our cleansing game. Cleansing is the first part of any skincare routine. We're going to be using products to get all the dirt, makeup, pollution, smoke, sweat, anything that's gathered over the course of a day, we need to make sure that that is off of our skin so that we can have healthier and stronger barrier function. It is important for our skin to be freshly cleansed so that our skin is a clean slate to receive all of the good skincare products that we put on for our night routine. This will enable our skin to be healthier and happier, and it will anti-age better. There's definitely pros and cons to drugstore cleansers. The pro side is that most of these companies have been around a long time. They are very large companies and they have a lot of research and development behind all of their products. So they've studied it, a lot of people have tried it, and it has been deemed safe and generally effective. And it has been that way for a long time. It is easily accessible. I mean, literally just down the street for most of us. It is also at a price point that is lower and usually accessible for the general public. This is a good thing because I think that is the one area of your skincare that you should definitely not be spending tons of money. My best tips for an effective cleanse. So there are 3 rules of 2. So one is cleanse twice a day, morning and night. Most people will benefit from twice a day cleaning. Obviously, at the end of the night, we need to make sure that all the dirt and makeup and sweat and pollution from the day gets cleansed off. But in the morning, we also have been sleeping all night. We have been sweating. Any residual oil or dirt from the night, it won't be definitely as much as during the day, but we still need to make sure that we cleanse that off of our face. Some of us with very dry skin can get away with once a day, but for most, 2 times a day will be optimal. Rule 2, when you cleanse, you're gonna cleanse for 2 minutes. Most cleansing standards anywhere you read say generally 15 to 60 seconds, but I have found that if you cleanse gently and rub with your hands for 2 minutes, you will get a really optimum clean. And anything that is stuck in your pores or deeper down will definitely get moved to the top. You'll be able to get a proper cleanse that way. Rule 3, double cleanse. Especially for the nighttime routine cleanse, you will need to do a double cleanse, meaning not just one time, especially if we have a lot of dirt and oil and makeup on our face. We definitely want to make sure that our first cleanse is going to take off all of that. The second cleanse will definitely take off whatever the first cleanse did not. It will be a lot more thorough and a lot more complete. Your skin will thank you. So if you are a huge waterproof makeup or mascara wearer, you definitely will want to do that double cleanse. The first step in that double cleanse will definitely mean that you will want a balm or an oil to break down that waterproof makeup. So if you're interested in seeing a video on those, please subscribe and let me know so I'll do a future video for you on cleansing balms as well as cleansing oils. So what should we be looking for in a cleanser? The ideal cleanser cleans but does not overstrip your skin. It is definitely lower in preservative. Sometimes there will be minimal amounts of preservative, but we definitely want to minimize that. The ideal cleansers will be low or absent of things like fragrance and parabens and harsh surfactants. And we don't want coloring or oils that will be clogging. Certain oils will be okay. So the inky list of a product is all the ingredients that a product contains. They will be in order from most to the least on the back of a product. It's important to look at these ingredients to determine whether a product has the right balance of things that will work for your skin that you will enjoy using and stay stable, but it's also balanced with not doing harm to your skin. Some detergents are necessary for a product to work. Some preservatives sometimes are necessary for the product to stay stable for longer periods of time. We need to recognize what our skin type is. Sensitive skin types will definitely have to watch what ingredients are definitely in a product. We need to make sure that we educate ourselves. I'm gonna link 3 websites down below. A lot of good information about ingredients and those that are harmful or those that are neutral or beneficial. You can plug in an ingredient and you can research a certain ingredient that is on the Inkey list and you can find out some more information so that you can be a more informed consumer as well as user, so that you know what's going on your skin and what's not going on your face. For example, sodium lauryl sulfate is a surfactant, so a detergent that will be included so that the product can take off the dirt. Sodium lauryl sulfate is not a good product. There are a couple of other ingredients that have been developed that are in the same family, and that is sodium laureth sulfate as well as sodium lauryl circosinate. These are not as bad as the sodium lauryl sulfate, but you definitely still need to be aware of them. Alcohol also is sometimes sensitizing to certain people, and we need to know that isopropyl, SD, and ethyl alcohol are all not very good for your skin. So there is also a really good resource, Lab Muffin Beauty Science. She's here on YouTube. You should definitely look her up because she is also a wealth of knowledge regarding cosmetics and skincare and all the ingredients that go in it. I mean, it's important to know these products, but most importantly, we need to make sure that when we buy a product and we take it home, that we're definitely sticking to the same routine and only switching out one product at a time, so that if something happens, if we get a rash or we get sensitization to certain product, we will know which product that is. We need to make sure that we take note and we really observe what our skin is doing, and we definitely take action if it doesn't like a product, that we need to definitely switch it out for something that is better. Everybody's skin type is so different. Everybody's skin sensitivity as well as skin tolerance is different. So some people can use the harsher chemicals and they will never have a problem with it and it's effective and they've been using it for years. Some people will use ingredients that are not a problem for most of us and they will have a reaction to it. It is so different. It is important to know one's own skin type and really keep track and see what's making your skin happy or sad. So I have a good selection of cleansers from the drugstore in front of me. Some of these products I have purchased brand new to show you, but I have definitely used all of these at some point in the past. Some of them I love and some of them not so much. I will go from my least favorite to my favorite. So here we go. So let's talk about this guy. This is the Cetaphil. This is the gentle skin cleanser. And if you read it, it says it's for sensitive skin and it's recommended by dermatologists. This has been around forever. My dermatologist recommended this to me when I was a teenager. And I don't think the formulation has changed much. I mean, it does work and a lot of people have been using it for a long time. I just think if you're gonna use it, just be careful and keep track of what it's doing for your skin. So this next group of cleansers from the drugstore are definitely less offending than the one I just showed you. This one is the Ultra Gentle Daily Cleanser. This is the Creamy Fragrance Free from Neutrogena. This one is also a really good cleanser. I've used it and loved it in the past. This one is also really good. This is a simple moisturizing facial wash. This one is the Hydrating Cleansing Hydro Boost Cleanser. I know a lot of people like this line. There are some of the offending ingredients in some of these, but again, let's just keep track of what it does for our individual skin. If you have acne-prone skin, these two cleansers have worked for me in the past. This is the Atmosphere Tea Tree Oil Facial Wash, as well as the Clear Complexion Cream Cleanser with salicylic acid. This next group is a little bit pricier at the drugstore, but it is a really good line that I'm currently using sometimes and I really like it. This is the La Roche-Posay line. And they have several different types depending on your skin type. This one is the Dermal Cleanser. This one is more like a cleansing milk. This is for your makeup and at the end of the day. There's a purifying foaming cleanser for more oily skin types, as well as a Lipikar and Tolerian. These are for more dry to sensitive skin types. And all of those work really well. The last three, which are definitely my favorite and my go-to, I find these cleansers always work no matter what stage your skin is at and how sensitive it is, depending on if you've been using actives or you've been in the sun. They're very rarely irritating and they have a lot of good ingredients. I mean, it's in the name, it's CeraVe. They have ceramides, as well as a couple of them have niacinamide, and they are just, there is a reason why these are so popular. They're just really good ingredients with a minimum amount of the harsh ingredients. So this one is the Foaming Facial Cleanser. This is the one that I use. This is for normal to oily skin. That works really well to clean everything off without stripping. And this one is the Hydrating Cleanser. It's a more emollient and non-foaming cleanser that works well for normal to dry skin. I do use this one even though I am an oily skin type. Sometimes if my skin is parched from being too dry, having used my actives, I find this one works really well. It's a little bit more soothing, especially if I haven't been wearing too much makeup and I just need a really good creamy cleanser to support my skin and not dry it out too much after actives. This one I find is really good too. And then sometimes I'll have a rough bumpy patch where I'll be breaking out, especially that time of month. I find this SA cleanser. This one contains salicylic acid and I find this one is really effective as well. Perfect example of cleansers that sometimes have a little bit stronger detergent or preservative are the two current favorites that I am using from the drugstore. So I don't know if these will work for everybody, but for me, they work fantastic. And they are the Neutrogena Ultra Light Cleansing Oil. And this one is the Rapid Wrinkle Repair. This is a prep cleanser for your actives at night. These are a little stronger, so they're not gonna be for everybody. But for me, they work really well and I did want to include them even though they're not completely preservative free. I find for my skin type especially, I don't know how you guys are, let me know in the comment section below definitely what works for you. But for me, I find that I definitely have to be very intuitive with my skin. I gotta listen to it. So some days my skin will be a lot more normal. Some days my skin will be a lot oilier or a lot rougher. I'll be dealing with a lot more breakouts. And some days my skin will be a lot more sensitive. I think you need to listen to your skin. I'm really interested to know what drugstore cleansers you guys use, and if you have any suggestions, please leave your comments down below and press that like button if this was a helpful video for you, and share with anybody that might need to know about drugstore cleansers. I would love it if you would subscribe and hit that notification bell, and I'll see you next time. Charlie? Which drugstore cleanser would you pick?
Oh, shit.